Peggy, this is basically your review lesson on September 28th, 2020. We talked about the grip before we started recording, and you know, we marked it up and gave you like kind of a reminder grip that you need to, you know, get out that old glove, that right-hand glove that's marked up, and get into that and actually practice and play with it. Okay, so the posture's pretty good. If I change anything, a little flex in the knees, you know, that lower leg should be a little lean forward, which means there's just a little flex in the knees, but it's not causing any great trauma. I like to see that eye line up just a little bit higher. But overall, the posture is pretty good. Okay, and the takeaway. Okay, so the good news here is that when the shaft is parallel to the ground, first parallel to the ground, it's about parallel to your toe line. Another good thing, the toe of the club is up. That's good. The bad thing is you've kind of taken it down. The butt of the club started at the green line. And now, early on, it's 6 inches away from your body. Now, on the takeaway, you know, I talked about the hand plane. If I rotate the shoulders, the butt of the club has to come inside like this, right? What happens to you is you throw it out here, and then you kind of screw up the swing plane. And then we've got our hands out here. Everything is just kind of screwed up. So what we want to do is, you know, kind of cement in this Y of the club and the arms and just rotate. You know, if you look down, look at the butt of the club, it'll go slightly inside. So at this point, the shaft should be parallel to my toes, and the butt of the club should be almost pointed at my hip, like this, as opposed to here. So, now what I'll do is, see, you can see the toe that goes, see how it overlaps his hand, and it's right up parallel his toe line. Yours is out here, I'll circle this. This is the head of the club. And, but here's the real problem. You can get by with that, but you can't get by with your hands being 6 inches away from your body. Yeah. So I'll capture this. So now, so that's step one, and that's going to set things up. So you got a grip that's kind of suspect, and then you got your hands away. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of reasons we won't go into it now, but it's a high risk position. Okay, so now the good thing is, here's the shaft, and here's where the plane is. So at this point, where the arm is parallel to the ground, here's the butt of the club. Still outside of where it started, right? So the butt of the club is starting my toe line. It's here. Even here, it's outside my toe line. Now, when it's halfway back, it should be here. Your hand should be over your bicep from that position. So So, see, my hand is in this path, your path is here, and like this.
I'm not turning.
Exactly. Okay. Well, you're not turning, but you're independent movement of the hands and arms. Yeah, exactly.
It's kind of like this
and rotate. Where are my hands going? They're going inside.
They're not going on pins.
Right. So that's what we're doing. We're just rotating, but at an angle. They're still rotating. They should come gently inside. They have that little hand path.
Okay.
So our hands are clear out here. Now you're getting it around you where it's not in a bad position at this point. Got a little funky thing here with the wrist. It's bent, but I think that's mostly because of the grip. But at the top, this the butt of the club should be about your heel. So it's still that far away. Okay, now, I do like the way this elbow is pointed. You know, there's like, 17 degrees off of vertical. Really a good spot. The club isn't drastically off plane. So that part's good. The part that's not good is your head started here. The middle of the ear started here, it's now here. So, if your chin's down, and you don't rotate the shoulder bumps into your chin, you know your hands are supposed to be somewhere here, so you gotta lift so your head comes up. So that shoulder has to go under your chin to get your hands up where they should be and keep your head still. The trouble is this, you're 6 inches here, now you've got to find ground. So you got to let that shoulder go under. Like that. That's the biggest. The other stuff isn't catastrophic. This is. You can't play with the head going up 6 inches. So we'll station. We'll fix that. Okay. So as you come down, and keep in mind this vertical green line is where the butt of the club started right here. Where the green line intersected the yellow line. Because here's the swing plane, here's the shaft of the dress. And here's the grip of the dress. So when you come down, see, it's just too steep. See this blur outside your hand? That's because of hands here, and you come down, you're going, how do I get the club head to get to the ball? You're coming like this. If you had it on plane like this, and the hands are inside, look, you come down, you come at the ball this way. You got this action coming on. It's the wood shot.
Is somebody at the door?
Yeah, it's gotta be the delivery guy or something. No, I never showed up. Okay, so, and that started from at the top position. So you got a wood shop thing coming in. And look at this, you can actually see the club thing. See how open it is?
Mm-hmm.
But that you're just trying to save at this point. You know, you're a pretty good athlete. You know there's going to be trouble here. My hands are outside the ball, and they've got to be in here to hit it.
you know, so you're just trying to save it with your hands, you know. The good news is you keep the hip pockets against the back wall. That's really good. I think when we started, it wasn't that way. So that part is good. Okay. So let's just go through it just quickly. As bad as this swing is, as far as coming down on the right plane, when you come down, you keep the right heel on the ground, and it's supposed to look like this. You remember we're talking about you haven't had years of, if you skip the rock, you come out like this on your toe, you're trying to skip a rock like this, you're actually going to screw up your back. If you come through, and the way it should be done is, if you come through, you're throwing the club, you get to the toe, and you're rotating through like this. So that's the swing that you haven't had because you haven't played baseball or tennis for 100 years or something. So we've got to get into this motion where we release through. At first, you couldn't release because you're coming in like this. If you release with Adam Scott, turn just be like going behind you because you're so steep. So what we have to do is round it out. But once we round it out, then we can turn through. We kind of see the difference. So, but this is late in the game. We've got to get rounded out when we're coming down to get through. Again, we're covering an infinite number of details. We're going to back all these out and get the 1.5 concept. Okay. And, you know, just kind of for Gary. Now, let's look for the other dimension. There should be no surprises. And this is what you mentioned to me the other day, Gary, is this will showcase it.
Yeah.
Okay. So as you go back, you got to think of this as a barrel. See that? That right hip has gone 4 inches out. That
adds another set of problems. So you got to figure,
you have to feel
like this is a barrel, this is the side of the barrel, and as I rotate, nobody's space here, like a ball with here. So it's a rotational thing. You've got a linear thing where you're swaying this way, and then swaying this way. Now, swaying this way, if you don't sway enough back, you'll
pop
the ball. Or hit it fast if you sway too much. So it's a rotational thing. So as this goes back, like that. So the different areas is there's a five rotation and there's a swing plane that we try to keep it on. Those are the two different areas. You can't work them together. You've got to work them independently and then mend them together.
But this sway thing is saying the body rotation isn't quite right. Now when you come down, so when you come down, you know, that's a classic chicken wing.
But the chicken wing comes from, so you sway this way, and as you're coming down, you don't clear the hip,
you'd have to go to the chicken wing because that's how our body works.
Yeah.
If I clear the hip, look, I end up nirvana, just like this. So you're coming down, and it's not rotational. You've got a kind of a sway through here, and it'll look like that. So what we want is rotational. We're here, here, here.
Mm-hmm.
And across the linear, like that.
Yeah.
I mean, that's why you finish your swing like this, as opposed to
So, okay, let me stop recording a minute.